Happening, folks. Back with another reaction, back with some more Bee Gees, and we're going back to the Timeless compilation 2017, and it's been enjoyable, as I've come to understand through people's awesome and informative comments, that the tracks I've already gone through come from a wide array of their releases and over a number of different years and indeed decades, so that's an enjoyable thing. Someone was actually commenting on that you know, compilations tend to be like that you get bits and pieces from different parts of their legacy. Hello, Luca. And yeah, we're going to listen to the tune Tragedy. It's a straightforward concept. It's not just something sad. It's not just a disappointment. It's a tragedy. It's an absolute, you know, utter loss of anything, you know, salvageable, or it's basically, you know, the worst possible outcome given the figures or the people involved. You know, sonically, that would maybe make me think it could be somber and slow and melancholic, but you know, there's a lot of music I've been going through from some different groups where sad or at least unpleasant themes are presented in an upbeat and euphoric sonic atmosphere and giving the track a sort of, you know, internal tension, and likewise there can be tunes which have bright and uplifting themes but which are very dark and heavy sonically. So I wouldn't say it's a guarantee, but I would say it is perhaps a possibility that the tune will be a bit somber. But we'll see. This is Bee Gees. The tune is Tragedy, and we hear it here as part of the 2017 compilation Timeless. Oh. Not somber at all.
Thank you.
their tunes to the next level. Tragedy, but a monumental triumph of the song. What a tune. That's honestly one of my favorite songs I've heard from them. And I put that, you know, on the same level, a different kind of tune. It's still, like, flaring up. But I put it on the same level of, you know, Too Much Heaven or, you know, basically any of their, like, real big hit tunes, Staying Alive and so on. That's just a fantastic track. Again, it felt like maybe that's a 70s tune. It had a bit of that, you know, it could have been on the soundtrack to Saturday Night Fever. I'm less certain about that one, whereas the other two that I've heard from the soundtrack, I had this sense that I think it's in that movie, right? This one didn't strike me in that way. But either way, I wouldn't be surprised to learn that's a 70s tune from them. But maybe later 70s, because again, there was some synth bass in there, I think. I don't think it was just like proper like bass guitar. I think there was actually some synth bass in there. And it was, you know, there was some gurgly moments where, again, a lot of the track, there's a lot going on. But there are a couple moments where I keyed in on it and there was a dynamic synth bass. And again, there's just all these different elements, that amazing guitar that would come back in moments. The vocal flares, which I'm going to assume that was Barry. Again, I know they can all do like some amazing things and have different range, but if I had to guess, I would say the lead there was Barry. Is that right? And yeah, some of the vocal flares in the lead, which again, maybe Barry, that was just incredible. Like, I can't believe it. So yeah, ultimately vocally fantastic. The composition, I love that moment where it sort of gave a dead pause and then rolled right back in very powerfully. Just the arrangement and composition of their tracks, as I said, is sort of next level, which I'm realizing more and more. But yeah, bottom line, that's one of my favorites from them, like, period. You can stop the sentence there. So yeah, there's only, I think, a few more on this compilation. In the immediate future, I'll have to see what I can do to, go through more Bee Gees after this, but I'm assuming that either through the person making this deep dive available already, Adam, or through others, there might be more Bee Gees that we can go through. So either way, we'll go through the remaining handful of songs on this compilation first, and then we'll figure that out. Do let me know what you think of this one. I do apologize, Luca, but I am going to have to pick you up. But yeah, I'll see you next time. Peace. Right back to the chair.